I thought we could have a go at doing some jam jar geology, looking at how sedimentary rocks are formed. Now, you might have wondered how you get stripes in rocks. You can see there's a coarser layer of sand here, and then finer layers of silts and clays as you go up through this rock. And this is formed by a sedimentary process, and we're going to have a go at creating our own sedimentary process via making a storm in a teacup. So if there's a storm, the water from all the excess rainfall can wash out some coarser sediments. So you might have some gravel. So I put some gravel in my teacup. You might have some sand that's also washed out. Some sand in my teacup. And obviously you've got all the water that's causing the sediments to be picked up. So we've got some gravel, some sand and some water and lots of high energy. So to create our storm in a teacup, we're going to swirl this round. When the storm stops, sediments are very rapidly deposited. And for this, we're going to just pour it into this jam jar. And you can see some of the gravel has settled out first. Then you've got some sand on top of that. And then just coming out here, you've got some silts. So the very fine material. And last of all, there is some clay that's still suspended in the water that hasn't settled out yet. It can take quite a while for that to settle out because it's very fine. So here's one that's been standing a little bit longer, and you can see some of the layers there a bit more clearly. So this process here is exactly what happens in sedimentary deposition. You get the coarser layers at the bottom, and then as that storm event or that event has subsided, you get the settling out of the layers upwards, causing the stripes in the rock. So have a go yourself. If you want to reactivate the storm, you can just have a swirl again and see it settle out.